Have you ever wondered how heavy an elephant is? This is Hannibal, the world's strongest strongman. He's going to try and lift an elephant. Well, Bimbo is only a baby elephant, but she weighs just over 1,000 kilograms. That's just over a metric ton. So let's see if Hannibal can lift her.
Today, Science All Around is about weighing. We're going to find out why we need to weigh things, how we weigh them, and how we make sure the weights are correct.
Weighing is a comparison between whatever you want to weigh and a fixed weight known as a standard weight. Our standard weight is the kilogram. It's useful and important to have a standard weight to compare things with, because all over the world, people who buy and sell things by weight will know what everyone else means. A fine cod fillet, weighed and priced. But do you know the world record catch is a man-eating shark weighing 1,208 kilograms? 530 grams of sausages at 70 pence per kilogram. That's 37 pence, please. But do you know the world's largest sausage weighed more than 400 kilograms? The largest cheese in the world weighed more than 15 tons. And the largest meat pie, nearly 6 tons. But have you also heard of weight limits? All babies are weighed at birth and regularly afterwards to keep a check on their growth. You should always keep a check on your weight.
65 kilograms.
If you are overweight, it can be dangerous.
One at a time, please.
One of the heaviest men who ever lived was Daniel Lambert of Leicester, who weighed in at 335 kilograms. Not a very pleasant sight. Daniel Lambert was 167,500 times heavier than the smallest mammal in the world, the pygmy shrew, which weighs about 2 grams. And it would take 5,450,000 pygmy shrews to balance the world's heaviest recorded land mammal, an African bush elephant, which weighed 10.9 tons. That's 10 tons, 900 kilograms.
Now, Toto isn't the heaviest elephant in the world, but surprisingly enough, elephants do have to be weighed. In fact, all the elephants that you see in zoos and circuses have all been weighed. Come on. That's the go.
Elephants are transported by air to zoos and circuses. The airline needs to know how heavy the elephant is to decide which aircraft can safely carry the weight and how much to charge for the journey. And even on dry land, there are limits to how much weight a lorry or a bridge can take.
Toto has grown quite a bit since she was last weighed. In fact, she'll continue to grow and put on weight for a few years yet.
Nellie the elephant packed her trunk and said goodbye to the circus. Off she went with a trumpety trump, 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 trump. Nellie the elephant packed her trunk and trundled back to the jungle. Off she went with a trumpety trump, 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 trump.
Well, we're off to weigh Toto. But before you find out how we weighed her, listen to the ideas we got from some children. First of all, Jonathan.
I've got the scales, which I use in the baker shop or in the sweet shop sometimes. And I've got the elephant in one of the pubs and blocks of with tons marked on them in the other one.
Now, John.
On this one, the elephant gets on the scales and then the clock works and then where it stops, little blocks come down with the elephant's weight.
And David.
This is my idea of how I'd weigh an elephant. In the middle of the picture, there's the weighing scales. The helicopter is bringing in more weights to weigh the elephants. And the crane is putting the weights on the weighing scales.
Finally, Nicola.
Well, you have a tank and you get an elephant and you lower him into the tank and specially treated water overflows and is sucked down into a compartment and it shows how many tons or how many kilograms of water that the elephant's made overflow. And you feed this into the computer and that tells you how much it is in metric.
This is a weighbridge, and it can take up to 50,000 kilograms. That's 50 tons. Right. Got it. That's it. Whoa.
We're on now.
Would you like to tell the driver to jump out?
The driver and his mate to get out. Okay.
First of all, the weighbridge is set up until the two arrows are exactly balanced. Now, print it out.
Bye, sir. Thanks very much. So the weight of the truck, the trailer, and the elephant altogether is 16,360 kilograms. Right, now let's take away the elephant.
Kill him!
Without Toto, we can find the weight of just the truck and the trailer, and so calculate Toto's weight. Once again, set up the machine until the arrows are balanced.
Thanks very much. So the weight of the truck and the trailer on their own is 14,590 kilograms. Now, 16,360 kilograms minus 14,590 kilograms. That's 0771. That's 1,770 kilograms. And that's the weight of our elephant. Now, let's check that by weighing Toto on her own. Thank you. 1,770 kilograms, and that's our elephant, and that's the same as before. There's only one more thing now. How do we know that this weighbridge gives the correct weight? Checking weighbridges is carried out by inspectors who work for local authorities throughout the country. We filmed them at work on a weighbridge in Chelmsford. The iron weights are rolled onto the weighbridge two at a time. Each roller weighs 500 kilograms, that's half a ton. Inside the office, the scale is checked by the inspector. 1,000 kilograms, one ton. That's just as it should be. Now they add another two rollers, bringing the weight up to 2 tons. And another correct reading. The men go on adding weights two at a time, and each time a ton is added, the scale is checked by the inspector. 3 tons on the weighbridge, and all correct so far. The inspector's job is very important. Because he uses the same roller weights on every weighbridge he checks, the inspector makes sure that whichever weighbridge you go to, you will always get the correct weight. But with all the bumping and banging and rolling the weights get, they may get damaged, and this may affect their weight. To make sure that they are accurate, the inspector checks each half-ton roller every 6 months on a special weighing machine. The machine is known as a comparator because it compares weights. First of all, the balance is unlocked, and the reading on the scale at the bottom is noted. In this case, right in the middle. Now, the roller weight is replaced by 25 standard weights, each of 20 kilograms. 25 by 20 kilograms is half a ton. Unlock the balance, and again check the reading on the scale at the bottom. It's in the same place, in the middle. So, compared to the standard weights, the roller weight is correct. But these standard weights, known as working standard weights, because they're in use every day, also need to be checked regularly. This is done by comparing them with the local authority standard weights. Here are some of the standard weights kept in Chelmsford, from 20 kilograms down to 100 grams. Each set, when it's made, is carefully checked, given its own number, and stamped with the highest authority in the land. Finally, a certificate known as an indenture is issued, authorizing the use of the weights.
This indenture witnesseth that the local standard metric weights have been compared and stamped for use in the County of Essex. The weights from 20 kilograms to 1/100th of a gram are numbered 5363. In witness thereof, the Controller of Standards has set his seal this 16th day of December in the year of our Lord 1949.
The weights are never touched by hand. The inspector always wears gloves when the local authority's standard weights are compared with the working standard weights on this beam balance. The beam, or lever, is pivoted in the center and has a scale pan on each end. On the right scale pan, the inspector puts a working standard weight. On the left scale pan goes the local authority's standard 20 kilogram weight. With the glass doors shut, so that the balance is not upset by any puff of air, the beam is raised on its pivot, and in this case, it balances. By regularly checking their working standards, the inspectors make sure you can rely on the kilogram. But there are many local authorities, all with their own standard weights. To make sure that a kilogram in Chelmsford is the same as a kilogram anywhere else in the country, all local authority standard weights are checked every 5 years by the Department of Prices and Consumer Protection. And to make sure the department gets it right, their working standard weights are checked every 5 years by scientists at the National Physical Laboratory in Teddington. Here, locked away in a cellar under this building, is the National Standard Kilogram. Today, you're going to see something that has never been filmed before and will probably never be filmed again, as the National Standard Kilogram is brought out only once every 5 years. This is the National Standard Kilogram, number 18 in the world. Made from platinum iridium, it's worth more than £3,000 for the metal alone. The balance that is used to compare the weights is one of the most accurate in the world. The National Standard Kilogram is used to check two reference standard kilograms, which are in turn used to check the laboratory's own working standard weights. First, the national standard, then the reference standard, are carefully positioned in the center of the scale pans. The rings make it easier to position the weights correctly. If the weight is not exactly in the center, then when the pan stops under each scale are lowered, the pan may sway from side to side and give a false reading. Both pans are checked and then changed round and checked again. When the scientist is sure the weights are in the center, the airtight lid is lowered and the balance and weights are locked up and left overnight. The next morning, the weighings begin. The scientist is going to find out exactly what the difference is between the national standard and the reference standard. the balance is worked from outside the room, and any small movement is magnified by a light reflecting from a mirror onto a scale. The movement across the scale is recorded. The balance is so sensitive, it can detect a difference of one part in 1,000 million. After recording the readings, the pan stops are raised and the pans changed over. The scientist takes many readings, each time noting the movement on the scale. In this way, he can find out exactly the difference between the national standard and the reference standard. The greatest care must be taken, because it is on the work of this one man that the accuracy of all the weighings in the rest of the country depend. But that's not all. The national standard kilogram and all the other national standards in the world are checked every 20 years with the international standard kilogram in France. This system of checking by comparison with standard weights means that whenever and wherever you buy by weight, you can be sure of the kilogram.
Well, the inspector was here just over 3 weeks ago checking this machine, so we can now be sure that we have Toto's correct weight. And now it's back to the surface.